start things up, I just decided to go in a little early and just kind of hope that come in. Let's see. For those of you who have not yet seen this show, we're only in our second episode, so don't hold that against us. This is the Drunken Fools of Wrestling podcast. Like I said, only a second episode. Just waiting for some folks to come in. Oh, who's watching? Ashton, JoJo. Do we have Fisherboy 1122? Okay. And we are live. Okay, so today was my first day off in about a week and a half almost. So I am kind of sleep deprived. I'm kind of tired. Okay, I got a pen. When Sean comes in, we're going to do something interesting. So, yeah, we're going to do something interesting when Sean comes in. In the meantime, I'm going to live off of these tips that you now gives me. Hey, JoJo. I'm here. Let's see. I'm just waiting on folks right now. Waiting on the folks. Oh, hey, we got some people. We got some people. Hi, everybody. Welcome to the Drunken Fools of Wrestling podcast. Today we are going to talk about a whole bunch of different stuff. But I'm pretty much going to wait until Sean comes in. In the meantime, if you guys would like to discuss anything, please let me know. Somebody say hi. I will start up the chat. Say hi to everybody. What would you like to know about me? What would you like to... Oh, Ashton, I am doing very well today. Like I said, it was my first day off in about a week and a half. My blood type is practically Arizona Arnold Palmer iced tea lemonade combination drink, but I am fine. I am perfectly fine. I can do a roll call and tell people to chat if they are watching, and I implore it. Tell your friends who are wrestling fans if they are wrestling fans, please, you know, let them be heard. Sean will be here momentarily. I'm going to go ahead and send him a message. I told him I'd be on in 5 minutes, and that was like 7 minutes ago. But anyways, today on the show, we are going to go through the 30-day wrestling challenge list, a few more of those. When will Trivia Pursuit Part 2 be released? That is a good question. Sean is working on that. He typically tells me when those drop, or when he's done, or about close to being done. So I'll let you know as I know. And, you know, like I said, Sean will be here later, and you can ask the Beardman about that himself. Meantime, another thing that we're going to talk about is NXT TakeOver The End, which happened on Wednesday. It was a fantastic show. We're going to do our review about that a little later on. We're going to talk about some things. Also, we are going to, me and Sean agreed to this a long time ago when we started the idea of the podcast. Since they are going to be doing a draft in the WWE soon, now that SmackDown is becoming a live show, me and Sean have agreed to do our version of the draft. So each of us will receive 10 picks, and we'll do one right after the other and all that fun stuff. And yeah, and whatever other shenanigans that we want to get into, because that's what we get into here best, is shenanigans. Can you hear me okay, Ashton? Just let me know if you can hear me all right. All right, so if there's anything else that you would like to know, please. I'll go ahead and let Sean know that we are live. And okay, Sean has told me that Sean's told me that he's going to be on in about a minute. You know, Sean has been doing a little traveling before he goes to Atlanta. I think right now he's in Chapel Hill or Fayetteville, hanging out with. Yes. Basically, this was unique to us because this was our first time trying you now, and yeah, just we were. I actually found you now literally the night before we aired because we were trying to figure out how in the hell we were going to do this episode. You know, me and Jeff being in Kill Devil Hills and John, or not John, Sean and Jared being in Georgia. So, like I said, I was just, you know, typing things like how to do a simulcast online, and you now happen to come up, how to install you now, that the hubba dubba da with you now, and it was like I discovered the answer to everything about life itself that night, and yeah. I have to say, I am personally proud of the Pursuit SmackDown 5 episode, or, you know, the live stream. The episode, the actual edited products are still to be seen. And, yeah, and any other questions? And, like I said, Ashton, please, if you have any friends who are fans, oh, I love the first part, yeah, the Trivial Pursuit episodes have always been some of our most golden episodes. I think I explained it in the intro of Trivial Pursuit 5, with however many times we tried to do the intro, that I think it was like 4 years ago, maybe four. 4 years ago. Sean, I think Jeff were hanging at my house, and see, there's a little thrift store like 10 minutes walking distance from my house, and we decided, hey, you know, like, let's go check this out. You know, we did some board game playthroughs that we taped, and we just thought to ourselves, hey, why don't we try doing a live episode? Hey, why don't we try Trivial Pursuit? So we found about like 3 or 4 editions. We found about 3 or 4 editions at the thrift store for about like $9 all together. But it wound up being a sale day at that thrift store, so we got those like 3 or 4 editions of Trivial Pursuit for like under $5. I'm sorry. I read that first part feeling sorry, and then didn't read the second part of that statement. A new person is watching. I wonder who it is. It doesn't say. But anyway, yeah. Like. Okay. Here's Sean. Let me. If I can remember how it is. Sean, how is it that we got the simul going? Okay, so here we go. I think, yeah, okay. Anyway, so let's see. Sean, I'm trying to get up with you right now, so we can finally get it going on. Do I send you the request to simulcast, or do you send me the request? I'm trying to figure that out. You know, really and truly, if you would like to contribute your 2 cents, okay. So I click on your name, and it should say, okay. It's the camera with the face. Oh, it's the camera with the face. Okay, so I'm trying to click on you, dude. Let's see, Ashton Art. Okay. It's the camera with the face. Ah, damn it. Okay. So, Sean, get online, Sean, and I will click you. And I think from there we can. Do you have your camera on? Is one of those things. Ah, shit, biscuits. Okay, Ashton, I'm trying this with you just to make sure that we. Okay, there we go. All right, is the camera safe?
Hey, dude.
Sorry. Hey, how's it going, brother?
It's good. How are you?
Good, man.
I know it might be weird that I'm pretty young, but I just must say, I absolutely love your guys' content. I really appreciate you guys.
Appreciate that. You know, it's always good to hear from fans.
Yeah, and my parents actually really don't care if I watch you guys because they actually think you're pretty funny too. So.
Well, that's awesome.
Give them a shout out when you see them. What? Sorry. It's sometimes with like guest broadcasting, the camera sometimes gets a little buggy. So.
Yeah, I did notice that when we were doing
and how the camera gets buggy, it's like, sometimes when the camera gets buggy, your voice gets buggy. I'll camera with the face because I'm using my phone right now.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah, I understand too.
And
when I was watching the live stream, it had a camera with the face, and actually, people who watch. Other people's live streams, they can click or touch the camera with the face, and they can actually request the live streamer to guest broadcast.
Oh, okay.
And nice to meet you too, Sean. So.
Yeah, man. So, yeah, we'll figure out how to get Sean on here. This pretty mug.
Yeah, I actually didn't. You could do a double broadcasting. Triple broadcasting.
I found this at like 3 in the morning, and I felt like I hit the gold rush.
I know, right? That makes your heart like, oh, this is amazing.
I would scream, but I'd be waiting for everybody in the house.
I know, I would scream.
All right, man. I think I can get up with Sean. I'm gonna drop you and see if I can get up with Sean. All right. It was awesome seeing you face to face, bro.
It's nice to see you too, man.
All right. Keep watching all your friends.
Heck yeah, I will.
All right, brother.
All right. You can try to get Sean on here.
All right, man. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Catch you later. All right. Ah, crap. All right. Oh, there we go. Cool. Yes! I feel accomplished something today. Oh, don't you love when you are able to do shit on your day off? Alright. So Sean will be on shortly, and I'm trying to figure out how to angle... But I'm but you know like but I understand that they need, you know, a strong tag team presence in NXT, and they're also the best thing in the tag team division right now.
Yeah,
like
yeah. I mean, if I was Triple H or William Regal, I would not want to call up Alpha too soon.
Exactly. I would say you know probably SummerSlam, if not right before Survivor Series.
Agreed. And that seems like a good time, because you don't want to call up Alpha too soon. They have, you know, we forget they really haven't been a tag team that long. What was it, like October, November?
Damn it.
It's been less than a year.
Yeah, it definitely has been less than a year.
Yeah, like and 8 months maybe.
Yeah, I want to say so far back as I think probably like September or something like that, but don't quote me on it. But
oh yeah, no, because they haven't been a tag team long, but it is long time overdue for Jason Jordan, who I know has been in NXT like at least 2 years, if not longer.
Yeah, like you know, he was definitely one of the like original enhancement talents, I think. But
okay, going even further back, maybe about 3 years then. Yeah,
something like that. But just I've seen his journey here to there, and yeah, just really and truly, you know, I think that Jason Jordan is one of my favorites for his struggle and how he got there.
Agreed. Yeah. Like, yeah, no, for sure. He deserves it.
Yeah. So anyway, so definitely thumbs up for Revival and American Alpha.
Yes.
Now, this match, Shinsuke Nakamura and Austin Aries. Holy shit, where do we begin with this?
I think we can sum this up. We'll talk about this, but I think we can sum this in three words. I think it's 3 words. This is awesome. Holy shit. That's all I gotta say. Wow.
It really and truly, it's almost like watching Joe Montana in his prime versus Steve Young in his prime, because it's just like, because you have Austin Aries, who debuted just before Shinsuke Nakamura, and then when Nakamura came in, Aries got overshadowed.
Mm-hmm.
Or probably not the best analogy. I'd probably say Drew Bledsoe, Tom Brady. You know, like you have Drew Bledsoe, who was the original. He was New England's golden boy. And then Tom Brady comes along, and we all know what happened from there.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, this is, you know, obviously they say dream match. They use that term a lot right now. This is Michael Jordan versus LeBron James right here. This is Derek Jeter versus, hell, Nomar Garciaparra in the heyday, you know? Like, what'd you say?
I said Babe Ruth. I mean, you know, like,
Babe Ruth.
I'm not much of a Yankees fan. You know that I respect them.
Right.
I'd say the Jeet is probably the number four Yankee of all time behind Garrett
Ruth,
and who the fuck else?
Probably Mantle.
Yeah, I'd say Mantle and DiMaggio. I think would be right under Jeter.
I like that comment right there from Ashton. Babe Ruth versus Reggie Jackson. Yes, that's another good comparison right there. Yes.
Tyson and Ali.
Tyson and Ali. Yeah, if you want to go the fight route, if you want to go boxing route, Tyson Ali. Hell yeah. So, in other words, this match was amazing. Yes.
Oh, yeah. I mean, the crowd was white hot for this match. And, you know, it would have been a good match, even if the crowd was dead as a doornail. But the crowd just made this explosive.
Yes.
Really, truly, I remember when I went to Serbia, I went to go catch a basketball game there. And I'll tell you, if you've never been to a European sporting event, those motherfuckers are crazy.
I bet they are.
Like, I went with a girlfriend's brother to this basketball game. And to kind of give you the story of it, the team that we were going to go see was Partizan, and they were taking on their rivals, the Red Stars. Now I think he was the owner of the Red Stars, or he was a coach or something like that. He used to be the owner of Partizan, but left and embezzled Partizan. So you know, all night there was all these chants, and of course you know Luca was translating for me. You know, he's just like, oh yeah, they're talking about how he should be in prison and he should be raped in prison, you know, like stuff like that. I mean, we wouldn't be able to get away with like a fraction of the stuff that they were chanting, man, in Europe.
Damn.
Yeah, dude. Like, I mean that's how white hot the Full Sail crowd was for Nakamura Aries.
Yeah, and sorry.
I think you froze. You're kind of like this, you know.
You're frozen too. Yeah, you're frozen too.
We're back. Okay. I'm only assuming it'll do that from time to time.
It will, just like when we did Trivial Pursuit. Like, I'm literally looking at your face. I should take a picture of this. Like, your face is kind of funny right now. Oh, one second. God. I'm going to take a picture. Oh, one second. Hold still.
Let me guess. You're going to share it all over Facebook. Chuck Beatty's next profile pic.
It's pretty funny. Here, check it out. See if you can see this. I don't know if you can see this. One second. Come on, phone. Come on. There you go. Check it out. Can you see this?
Yes. I have to say that's not a bad picture of me.
It's not a bad picture. No, but it's just like it. No, it's just like the picture. It just makes me think of that song. All I want for Christmas is my two front teeth.
Oh man.
Anyway, you're still frozen. Yeah, am I frozen?
Yeah. You look like you had a massive O face.
You should take a picture of my face too.
Fuck Drunken Fools of Wrestling. This will be the funny frozen picture hour.
Right? Yeah. Awkward family photos.
Yeah, find some kind of movie line to go with it. But anyway, all things considered, yeah, I really had nothing to say bad about this match. You know, like for me, it's a prime contender.
No, agreed. That does sometimes happen, Ashton. Yeah, no, this match is, I thought after Sami Zayn a match like super worthy of Nakamura's time. Like, you know, I didn't think they were going to have a match like this. Then Austin Aries debuted not that long after, and then people were like, okay, now it's going to get better. And I'm trying to think, like, if there's anyone else in that locker room right now in NXT that would make a dream match. I guess Nakamura versus Samoa Joe, eventually. I don't know.
I imagine that's what they do sometime on down the line.
You know,
one more time?
I said maybe they'll have Nakamura versus Samoa Joe for the World Heavyweight Championship, if we're so lucky. NXT Championship.
What, like at TakeOver Brooklyn, or...
Or just somewhere down the line, if they keep Samoa Joe in NXT, which seems like their plan right now after the World Heavyweight Championship, spoilers. Yeah, that seems like their plan, maybe. So.
I would hold off on Nakamura Joe. I wouldn't do it at TakeOver Brooklyn. I think that would be too soon. But
no, maybe probably, the next one. Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Like, you know, the TakeOver closest to the end of the year or the beginning of 2017. You know, that way you got plenty of time to build up Joe as champion. You got plenty of time to build up Nakamura as a viable contender. I mean, I know he is already, but, you know, just kind of give him a bit more of a road to go down.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Yeah. Don't do that now. I'm saying down the road, yeah.
Yeah, definitely. So, thumbs up for Nakamura Aries.
I'll give 2 thumbs up. I would give 4 thumbs up if I had more hands. So, yes. Okay, so if I was Goro.
4 thumbs up altogether. All right. So next one was Asuka versus Nia Jax, and this one was kind of a sleeper hit to me. Like I said, I wasn't expecting a great deal from this match, but it definitely exceeded my expectations.
Yeah, it did for me too. Because like I said, going into it, I'm not a big Nia Jax fan. I was really disappointed that Bayley didn't get a chance at the title. But I feel like these two put on a good match though. She'll get her chance,
to me it kind of felt like the build up to Hogan Andre from WrestleMania 3, in that you have, you know, the unbeaten world champion, you have the world champion or the women's champion in this instance, and then you have this big monster of a human being, you know, who's looking to have her way with Asuka and become women's champion. You know, like it did everything short of a female Hogan slamming female Andre.
Yeah, I think it did. It's really I mean, I'm sure it can be really tough to have those kinds of matches where you have two people of, like, complete and utter differing weight levels. And, you know, we saw that with Bayley and Nia Jax, and that was a good match. It ended up being a great match. So I was hoping for more of that. This wasn't as good as a Bayley match, but it was still good.
Yeah, like, for me, Bayley versus Nia Jax was a viable contender for women's match of the year last year, if you ask me. And
was it last year? When did they face off?
It was at London.
It was at London? Okay.
Yeah, TakeOver London. And,
okay, I was trying to remember. Anyway.
Yeah, like, you know, Nia Jax, take her or leave her, but she can put on a great match if she wants to. So yeah, thumbs up for me.
I'll do one thumbs up for this one, yes.
Yeah. So anyway, the main
event. Oh, you went froze finally.
I was about to say you did about a minute ago. Hi, everybody. But,
yeah, you've been frozen for like 10 minutes. Anyway.
Let it go. All right. So main event. Yeah, I'll shut up. Main event, we have Samoa Joe, Finn Balor in a steel cage. And this match, I think, did everything that it was supposed to do.
Yeah, it did. It closed the chapter and kind of just let it go. I will say, let it go. Before we kind of get more into this match talking about, I will say it's my least favorite match, and I'll justify that in a minute.
Okay. Well, you know, it was a slower paced match than what we're expected of both of them. Yeah, like they both work a fast style. We all know this. That's no secret. So you know, I mean, the crowd was still hot for it, but you know, but I think that the energy of the crowd and Joe and Balor didn't quite sync up, which I think was the main thing that hurt the match.
I agree with that. Like you said, they usually work at a faster pace. The fact this was a cage match, I was definitely very hesitant about it. I was interested to see how Finn Balor would handle the cage. He handled it well, but I didn't like the stipulation about being able to escape the cage because it made for some stupid moments. It made for those moments where Finn Balor like takes a running leap at Joe when, hey, if you have that much energy to run, just run outside the door. So, I mean, there was a lot of stupid... And so that stipulation kind of hurt that in my mind.
There were a lot of fallacies of logic in cage matches. So if you're willing to kind of, I don't want to say suspend your disbelief on it, then sure, maybe you can get a little bit better enjoyment out of it. But I can definitely see your point. You know, like, I mean, pro wrestling does involve you to suspend your disbelief to astronomical levels at times. And I feel, you know, like it's really hard to pull off a good cage match in that respect and in that way.
Yeah, because NXT, I know wrestling's all about suspension disbelief, don't get me wrong, but in NXT, the reason I like NXT so much, and more so beyond the main roster, is because it does a lot of things where, yeah, that's believable, because it's based on the athletic, the gifted athletic abilities of these people, you know what I mean? Like, they pull off some amazing stuff, and they do it because of their abilities and their work ethic and their perseverance. Putting stipulations in and everything kind of just hurts them, because they're able to do this shit without those stipulations, like cage matches. And so when you have this kind of match where you're doing a cage match and like Finn Balor doesn't need that, Samojo doesn't need that, not in NXT, and because they have their abilities to go to fall back on. So that's why I was very hesitant, and my hesitance toward this match was I feel justified a little bit because it should never have been a cage match, but that's just me.
Well, I mean, I think that they needed to do something big to show everybody, hey, this is the big blow off to Finn Balor, Samoa Joe, and I'll tell you, the reason that I feel it needed to be a cage match, two words, super muscle buster.
Yes, the cage match was justified with that super muscle buster. That was amazing.
Yeah. So if for nothing else, I think that, you know, the super muscle buster justified the existence of the cage. So, you know, I know it wasn't your favorite stipulation, but I still got to give the one thumbs up on that.
I'll give like a half. I'll be like, eh, you know. That's what I'll go with here.
I'll give a thumb and a half to compensate. Nah, but I'll seriously just give the one.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, because, you know, no, I mean, I have nothing wrong with stipulations. I mean, you know, look at that that Asylum match between Ambrose and Jericho. These are two of my favorite performers, especially Ambrose. And to have that, I was just like, oh, God. But then it was justified with the tax, and I was like, holy shit. Exactly. So it had that one justification.
The reason, you know, the way that you make a stipulation match like that work is being able to use your environment to its fullest potential. And yes, Ambrose Jericho was slow at the beginning, but once they started actually using the contents of the cage and the cage itself, it justified even having it.
I agree with that. Once they actually started getting into to the swing of things.
Oh, and Ashton, to answer your question, we will be doing it after the mock draft.
How about
or after the mock draft, you know, like the Mad Lib.
Yeah, why don't Ashton? Do you have to go or something? I was just curious.
Yeah. Just let us know if you're on any kind of constraints or anything, and we'll get to it while you're here.
Yeah, if you're on a constraint, we'll do once we finish talking about NXT Takeover, we'll do a Mad Lib with you if you have to go. So.
And I think we're pretty much done with talking about TakeOver. I think we discussed all the fine points of the pay-per-view. Now for the final score. Out of a scale of 1 to 10, I have to give TakeOver the end and a solid 8.5.
8.5, yeah. I was going to probably give it an 8. I'll give it an 8 because, like I said, the main event, like I said, I was not a huge fan of the main event, as we just discussed. Every other match, pretty much, though, I was really happy about. The Women's Championship was okay. It was decent. But Almas versus Dillinger, Nakamura versus Aries, and the Revival versus Alpha just blew me away. So.
And we have another person in the thread whose name also happens to be Sean. So.
Oh, wow. Brothers! Brother! It's been too long. Damn, Sean 2499. How you doing, man? Anyway,
you can go all the way up to 2500,
right? I think I have like some stupid number at the end of mine. It's like 2177. I don't know, whatever it is.
I just put down my name in one word, Chuck Beatty. That's it.
Well, yeah, but when I first connected via Facebook, it gave me like numbers. Yeah,
I had
to do that after the fact.
I think I made the YouNow account independent of my Facebook and all my other social media. Okay, cool, Steve. I'll be damned.
Steve? I like you, Steve. You're a cool guy, but did you do that to, like, be me, or is that your real name? Because I'm a little,
The cool Steve saga continues.
All right, I'm flattered. Thank you.
All right. So anyway, that's
so Ashton. Sorry, go ahead, sir.
Anyway, that's our opinions of TakeOver the end. And
final thoughts. You have any final thoughts?
My final thoughts. Triple H, William Regal, keep doing what you're doing. You are making the future of pro wrestling today. And I mean, just, you know, if this is what the future of the WWE looks like, then I think we're in for some good shit, hopefully.
And I look forward to seeing what Paul Ellering and Bobby Roode are doing there.
Oh yeah. Oh god damn. How did I forget those?
Yeah, I was like, cause, yeah, exactly. Like I saw the segment with Bobby Roode. I'm like, wait, is that Bobby Roode?
Yeah, man. I know.
And then Paul Ellering coming out, and I'm really curious to see who those two big freaking guys are who beat Alpha. Do you know who those are?
I would tell you, but I have no idea.
But you'd have to kill me.
Well, that's it.
And Steve, come on, man, you can't wait for the WWE Scooby Doo sequel? Come on, dude.
What are you, 3?
Maybe he is. You know, maybe he is. Who knows? Okay, nah, I'm just kidding. We love you, Steve. Thoughts on the WWE Scooby-Doo sequel? I'm just kidding.
Like I said, we only joke. We only just we care.
We do care. He just agreed. Yes, I am. Anyway. that.
Anyway,
all right. Anyways. So do you want to? Sorry, go ahead.
So we'll do. We'll go ahead and do the Mad Lib, kind of as an intermission sort of thing.
Cool. Do you want me to get one of mine, or what do you want to do?
I didn't bring any of mine, so.
Okay, hang on 1 second. I think they're downstairs. So 2 minutes, folks.
Yep. Meantime, intermission time. It's the whole music. The whole music. Make live. I guess that's what it is. Try not to.
Hi. Hello. What's up?
What's
what I'm feeling right now.
Sean is grabbing some Mad Libs, and
do you still see Sean's webcam, or do you just still see mine?
I just use yours.
Are you kidding me right now? Are you kidding me right meow?
I ain't kidding you right meow.
No, kidding me right meow.
I only see my webcam going on. I only see yours.
Okay. Hey, I need to tell you something. I actually feel something right now. Can I tell you?
Go ahead.
Alright, do you know what I feel? You can say this one with me if you want. Alright, here we go. I feel S-A-O-U-F-E soft.
Yes. Oh, God. But anyway, right now we're in
the last live stream I watched, you should have, like, guest broadcasted me because you needed to see my face because I was dying laughing. my face was so red. And you guys gave me, like, a big smile. I was like, oh, my God, you guys are hilarious. And when we saw the final, like, product of your live stream, you guys got 460 viewers.
Oh, yeah, dude. I was most surprised.
That's amazing. That's more viewers that you get on than YouTube. I know for sure, right?
Bastards aren't really appreciative. We've been doing this 5 years. We're lucky to get 200 subscribers. Nah, but in all seriousness, though.
Seriously, that should be a higher number.
Yeah, I do appreciate that, brother.
I think it should be like 200,000 or maybe like even more, maybe like a million or something.
Word of mouth is the best for us, man. You know that.
Mm-hmm. If I saw someone that I think you guys would think they'd be a fan of, I need to get, like, friends and everything to come watch you guys, because I think they would love you.
Oh, yeah, like I said, Facebook, you can just shoot your...
You can share right now on you now, so...
Yeah.
So, yeah. When I was doing the guest broadcast thing, it had mobile pictures... for like screenshots of guest broadcasting. I thought you could do like three people at once. Because it showed that. I'm like, why does it only like do two? Because I thought it would do like more than that. I thought that's what you're now supposed to be.
Yeah, I think so.
And Sean just commented and said no triple cast. I really understand, so, Should I hang up?
I guess so, unless everybody comes to general consensus that you're the better, co-host.
Yeah, alright, so I can get Sean back. Yeah, get off my screen. Okay, alright.
Alright, brother.
Alright, see you, bro.
Alright, man. Let me just get Sean back on here. What the fuck are you talking about? All right, here we go. Sean's coming back on. Eventually. It's the whole music. It's the whole music. Pick up, Sean. These people are going to be at the mercy of my beatboxing skills. Do you want that? Do you want that on everybody's conscience?
Yes. Yeah, anyway. I see I got booted there, JoJo. Good to see you again, Ashton. Yeah, get on my screen, damn it. Anyway, that sucks. We can't do a triple cast. That sucks.
Yeah, oh well. You'll learn till you try, right?
Right. All right, so I got Boz Burrs and Foo Fighters. Let's do a Boz Burrs, because Boz Burrs is just awesome.
Yes, you can't do Bob's Burgers.
You can't. Me and I was hanging out with Audrey this weekend. We did one that was absolutely fucking perfect, and it ended up being absolutely just, oh my god. It was awesome. I'm trying to find that one. I'll read that one really quick, just because, like I said, it was one of the most perfect Mad Libs I ever put together. I was, like, really proud. Let's see, where is it? Shit. I want to say it was this one. Let's see. Yeah, this one? Was this one? Yeah, this one. Check this out. Ready?
You're in it.
Ah, shit, you froze. Come on, Chuck. Stop freezing.
Can you hear me, though?
Oh, there you go. You're unfrozen. Yeah, I can hear you, too. Good. Here, let's see. here, check this out. Ready? Grand reopening of Bob's Burgers. The night before the sticky reopening, Bob went to sleep worried the whole cursive handwriting was out to get him. He tossed and he parked into the night, imagining worst case candy asses for the restaurant. When he shockingly fell asleep, Bob had a nightmare. Luis and Tina had erased the dishwasher of the day from the chalkboard and were playing Hang Hamster.
Hang Hamster? Oh my God.
Linda was talking on the phone with Caleb Bradham, it's a UNC alum, who was demanding $1 of rent.
$1.
$1 of rent. Then an isosceles fell out of the sky. It fucked through the front Hillary Clinton's vagina of the restaurant.
now I no longer wonder why they got closed.
Seriously. Gene cried, "Damn, Daniel," to everyone's horror. Jennifer Lawrence had been crushed, but it was only a nightmare. The next day, the opening of Bob's Anchovies went without a hitch. The Belchers had 72 customers, but Bob still managed to keep the grandpa's ashes open.
Oh, Jesus.
Anyway, so that's what we came up with. I thought the best one was fucked through the front of Hillary Clinton's vagina. I was like, oh, God. So all that bullshit aside, sorry. I just really wanted to read that one.
Yeah.
Would you say, all right, kids? What?
Yeah, I said, all right, kids, let's top this one.
Let's try to top this one. Like I said, that was awesome. All right, let's see. There's not a lot left. All right, let's go with this one. Everyone ready? So I'll start with Chuck. Chuck, I need an adjective.
Adjective, I'm going to say belligerent.
Okay. All right, Ashton, sound off if you're still there.
Same thing, adjective?
Not for him, no. Ashton, as soon as you get this, I need a type of food. And then JoJo, maybe, if you're there. JoJo, give me a verb. And Chuck, give me a noun.
Noun. So, Cool Steve said pizza.
Okay, Cool Steve, thank you for the type of food. So, Cool Steve, that's right, I forgot you were here. I looked at the name Sean, I was like, why am I here twice? That's right, it's Steve.
Why am I thinking pizza?
Why? Why am I thinking pizza? You know what's funny? Jared's cooking pizza right now. Irony. So now.
I got some Caesars, bitch.
There you go. You have pizza too. We're just all having pizza. But yeah, a noun from Chuck and a verb. If you're there, JoJo, a verb from JoJo.
Noun. I'm going to say Ronald Reagan.
Ronald Reagan. Okay.
You can never go wrong with Reagan. In the game of Mad Libs.
In the game of Mad Libs. Yeah, coming from you, you can never go wrong with Reagan, huh? Coming from you. I'm just kidding. All right, Cool Steve, since you're there. Cool Steve, I need an adjective. And Chuck, give me a verb ending in ing.
Panting.
Panting, okay. Alrighty, so Cool Steve, an adjective, and then I guess maybe Ashton might be gone for a second. Ashton, as soon as you get this, man. Ashton, as soon as you get this, yeah, man, let me know and I'll give you one. In the meantime, Chuck, give me another adjective, a different adjective.
Sexy.
All right. There's a lot. There's quite a few adjectives in this. So go ahead and give me another one. Ashton, you're here. You give me an adjective as well. Adjective and adjective.
Let's see. Adjective. Let's see. Have I already said sweaty?
Not for this one.
I'm saying sweaty.
Okay. All right, wrinkly from Ashton. Okay, sweet. Oh, boy. All right, Ashton, since you're back, Ashton, give me a verb. And Chuck, give me an article of clothing.
Article of clothing. I'm going to say underwear.
Underwear from Chuck.
And Ashton has suck.
Has suck. For the what did I give you? A verb? Yeah.
Go.
Okay.
Play.
Play. Speaking of adjective, give me another one. Actually, there's two adjectives. Okay, Chuck, give me an adjective. And Ashton, give me a Ashton, give me a part of the body, plural. I'm going to you because you can keep this clean for us since you're a kid. Keep it PG, fella.
A public service announcement from Sean O'Keefe.
From Sean O'Keefe. So part of the body, plural, from Ashton and Chuck. What did I give you?
I gave you
an adjective. I'm sorry.
Oh, another adjective. Let's see.
Adjective gave me head. Ashton gave me heads. Okay. And adjective from Chuck. Yes.
Let's see. For adjective, I'm going to say... Sun-dried.
Sun-dried, okay. We're getting fancy.
Yeah.
From Chuck, how about a place from you, Chuck? And from you, Ashton, a noun.
Waffle House bathroom.
Waffle House bathroom. Let's see. Hang on. Waffle House bathroom. And I see you, Steve. Hang on one second. He gave me a couple adjectives, it looks like. So he gave me frightening and addictive. Let's go ahead and go with... I only have one adjective left, Steve, so let's go ahead and go with addictive.
Oh, yeah, addictive.
Addictive, and then it looks like he gave me dog for noun.
Yep.
Okay. Looks like we only have one left, so I'll go with Chuck on this one. A part of the body, singular.
Part of the body, I'm going to say uvula.
Uvula, and actually, I'm sorry, we actually have one more. So, whoever answers first gets it. Ready? Here we go, Steve. Here we go, Ashton. Not you, Chuck. Ashton and Steve. No, get your hand off the buzzer. Ashton and Steve, here we go. Ready? A verb ending in ing. Go. See who wins. And Ashton gets it with jumping.
Show us jumping.
Ding. All right, so the Mad Lib is complete. I don't mean a noun, but okay. I was kidding. We'll keep that in mind, Steve. Okay. Hang on one second. Let me take a swig of my concoction. And we'll be on our... we apparently had whiskey in the refrigerator. I think it belonged to Rachel, so I mixed whiskey and raspberry ginger ale. It's quite lovely.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Not bad at all.
Yes. All right, here we go. Ready? This is going to be a good one. Going, I meant to say, but oh, okay. My bad, Steve. Sorry, man.
I figured that's what it was.
I figured it was too, but I just love Goy because I am part Jew, so I was laughing at that. That was pretty funny.
Hey, Sean, did you get to this yet?
I got my coin operated Goy from Christmas. Oh boy, guys! Sorry, man. I'm gonna get my ass kicked for that accent one day. But anyway.
Yeah. Avoid all temples and synagogues.
And Bernie Sanders rallies.
If I had the balls to dress up as a strip of bacon for a Bernie Sanders rally, I'm sure that you'll be okay.
That's true. All right, so here's the Mad Lib. It's avoid the church. Yeah, definitely avoid the church there, Steve. Okay, Mad Lib. Our Mad Lib is Teddy Shrink.
Oh, good lord.
I love Teddy. He's one of my favorite characters.
Yes.
All right, here we go. Therapist. It's like dialogue between therapist and Teddy. Therapist. Are you feeling belligerent? Teddy. Bobby had me dress up like a pizza again. my uvula broke out in hives.
Oh, good lord. That's the worst place to have it.
Seriously. Therapist. What is it about Ronald Reagan costumes that you find so sun-dried?
That's so perfect.
He is like a raisin, or was.
Well, he's from California, too, so...
There you go, folks, check him out.
California raisins.
God, that's going back. Ashton, that was before your time. God, let's see. All right, Teddy. They're soulless heads. Oh, God. Therapist, what about when you wear the costume? Who is... Okay. Teddy, panting tearfully. Bobby could see my underwear sticking out. I was so addictive. Therapist, I see. And did you go to your wrinkly place?
Wrinkly place? You mean you scrotum?
Scrotum. Did you go to your wrinkly place? Did you picture yourself in the Waffle House bathroom? Oh, God, what have you done?
Corrupted an entire generation.
Wrinkly place in the Waffle House bathroom. Oh, no.
That sounds about perfect, though, for it, though.
Oh, yeah, check out the next line. Teddy, so did you go to your wrinkly place in the Waffle House bathroom? Teddy says, yes, and it was sexy.
Oh, no.
Yes, and it was sexy. What do you think it means? Therapist, I'm sweaty, but we're out of time. Let's pick up their next dog. Let's pick up their next dog. Not next week. Next dog.
Yep. All right. So, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, last week we did a few entries in the 30-day wrestling challenge. Let me bring that up again.
Shaka,
bro.
While you're pulling it up, I just watched I think it was the latest Botchamania, maybe, because it included clips from, well, it included Asuka saying, you talk too much from last NXT. Anyway, so it was quite good. It mainly covered Extreme Rules and basically made fun of Roman Reigns, just like, you know, just like Roman Reigns. Pretty much, just like Roman Mania. Did you see that one?
Yeah, I've seen Roman Mania.
I just don't even understand it, man. They're just ruining the guy.
Yeah, exactly, dude. I mean, there's no way that they can make him really good. I mean, it can only go fucking downhill from here. It's a Sisyphus situation.
Yeah, it is. I mean, I have nothing. You know what? I don't hate Roman Reigns. He's not a bad guy. He's not the good guy. He's the guy. But, you know, I just give him a simple gimmick where he beats the shit out of people. Doesn't talk much, just beats the shit out of people. He was good at it with the Shield.
Yeah, he was the good silent guy. You know, Seth Rollins did all the talking. Dean Ambrose did all the Dean Ambrosing.
And Roman Reigns did all the Roman Reignsing. So
yeah.
That's all you need. You just need him to do his Roman Reignsing. Don't let him talk. You know what he should have? He should have an advocate, kind of like Paul Heyman and Brock Lesnar. Don't let him speak. Yeah.
Exactly. But, you know, if they do it at this juncture, you know, that's, you know, damage has already been done, unfortunately, but...
Well, maybe. You never know. Maybe they could still save him. Anyway, all that bullshit aside, what do you got today?
Okay, so we left off at a favorite angle, right?
Yes, and my favorite angle was Kurt Angle.
Yes, obviously. My favorite angle was Isosceles.
Do you think Roman Reigns is... What was that? Okay. Oh, do you think Roman Reigns is stupid? The big guy is quite the cook. Yeah, unfortunately, the big guy probably is taking up cooking because he's no longer with him.
Yep. And if you watch season 2 of Swerve... You learn that Ryback can't grow hair.
Oh, no. I haven't seen any Swerve. Is he in the new season?
Yes. Him and AJ Styles prank this little 12-year-old kid who's making signs. I think AJ Styles was taking on Ryback or something like that. And, you know, AJ makes the suggestion to him to make a sign to the kid making a sign saying, Ryback can't grow hair. And then AJ leaves and Ryback comes in and sees the sign and then, you know, like, and then, you know, he's like, he's trying to save face, so Ryback's making him make a sign that says, AJ's hair looks stupid.
Yeah. Oh my god.
It was actually really funny, man. It was hilarious, but, anyway, here we are. Least favorite female wrestler, Sable Pichon.
Eva Marie. That one was easy. Do you want to talk about this, or you want to just leave it be?
I think if you've watched all of 1 second of Total Divas and or NXT, or even the pre-show from WrestleMania this year, you'll know. You'll know.
Yeah.
So that was quick.
Yeah. That was easy. Hits button. Yes.
All right, now we go to least favorite male wrestler. Sean?
Say it with me. John Cena! No. This one isn't as easy because John Cena is not my least favorite wrestler, contrary to popular belief.
Oh, yeah.
He's not even your least favorite.
Actually, no. He's not my least favorite.
Yeah, see, does that shock you, Ashton? Does that shock you, You Now World? John Cena, despite Chuck's hatred of him, is...
His gimmick sucks, but as long as he puts on great matches, couldn't care less.
Oh yeah, like his U.S. title matches with challengers, amazing.
Yeah, Open challenges, definitely the best thing. One of the best things about Raw this year, or last year.
Exactly, and yes, Ashton. Anyway.
But.
I don't know about that, Steve.
The Rock in his prime. Was one of the best things about wrestling of the late 90s and early 2000s. Rock in his prime.
I can't say, obviously, because I wasn't a fan, but I've seen some of his old promos. His promos were amazing. His matches were pretty good. Pretty good matches.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, like, he was able to get by mostly on personality. He was able to deliver in the ring as well, but people remember him as one of the greatest trash talkers of all time.
For sure. Easy there, Ashton. Wrong. No, there's no wrong or right here. I mean, you can say John Cena's better than The Rock. It's your opinion.
Yeah. Or you could be trolling us.
Or you could be trolling us. I love Rock's promo to Booker T in the school bus. Yes.
Booker T, why does 2 plus 2? Thomas Jefferson, sucker!
Oh, God. Check that promo out if you've never seen that. It's funny as hell.
Alec Asher, right, Steve?
But anyway, least favorite male wrestler. I'm going to say my least favorite male wrestler of all time Mantar.
Is he related to Rhino?
Well, basically what it was is like, it's one of the worst gimmicks ever in wrestling. Maybe even worse than dare I say, the Shockmaster. Basically what it is like you had this guy in this shit brown singlet.
Oh, God.
Like this giant like buffalo on him, and then like, you know, making his way to the ring. The buffalo head would like smoke from the ears or whatever, and all that. And then he takes off the buffalo head to wrestle, and it's just like a guy with like, you know, like black like eye mask, like right the fuck here.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Why?
And this was the era where a lot of people's gimmicks were basically day jobs.
That's fair. And Steve appears to say Dude Love for his least favorite. Or are you talking about promos? Dude Love promos.
I don't know. I think we're talking about least favorite wrestler still. But
that's a fair answer. If so,
I liked Dude Love. I mean, yeah, like it was hokey, but it's Mick Foley. You can't not love Mick Foley.
Yeah, I mean, without a doubt, it's probably his worst, quote unquote, worst gimmick out of all his gimmicks, but it still wasn't bad.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, like to me, Dude Love was that gimmick that Mick Foley had that was supposed to be so bad that it was good. Actually, it was actually. Mick Foley's first original gimmick was Dude Love. And, you know, like, you know, I think Vince McMahon gave him the green light to go ahead to be Dude Love. But we have a new person watching. Hello, new person.
Hi.
Tell your friends if you like us in all the 8 seconds you've seen us.
Right. I will say this, just in between, we should do this. If you're just joining us, welcome. This is the Drunken Fools of Wrestling quote-unquote podcast, quote-unquote. We're doing it via you now, but we are two idiots who talk about wrestling, and Ashton has a question. Yes, Ashton, what is your question?
Go ahead.
While we wait for your question, let's go ahead. I'll kind of think of my least favorite, unless do you have anything else to share about Mantar?
I think I just summed up Mantar in all of, like, 15 seconds. That's really all you can really do with Mantar.
All you have to say is Mantar, and people are like, okay, that's a good least favorite wrestler.
I remember, I think it was the Mantar debut, like, which wrestler was stupid?
The big guy's quite the scout. We will get to that. We'll do an impromptu one. Which wrestler is the most stupid? Okay, we'll get to that. Hang on.
Okay.
Let me think of my least favorite. Let's think of my least favorite first. I guess Chuck is the more hardcore wrestling fan. He's been a fan a lot longer. I just became a wrestling fan about 3 years ago, so I mean, I don't have a lot of history to go back on. So I'll give my favorite wrestler of the 3 years I've been watching it. I always hated The Miz, but he's not my least favorite. Let's see.
The first part rhymes with your name, and the last part is Dongo, right?
No, Fandango's not my least favorite either. I am Mantar.
No, Mantar.
That's awesome. You know, I feel like here's the thing about Mantar. Wherever you are, who portrayed Mantar.
I can't remember the guy's name right now.
Okay, well, if you're watching this, the guy who played Mantar, call up the director of Warcraft and see if you can get in on the sequel.
I mean, if they can get Mr. T with a Nighthawk, with the Mohawk grenades and shit, they
yes.
can get Mantar.
Yeah, I'm really surprised that Mr. T is not in the movie as the F9 Mohawk. What the hell? Hum's Batman theme. Stupid! No. Stupid!
Mantar!
Okay,
gonna be doing
let's
that
see.
My girlfriend's gonna kick my ass.
Charlie, what is this Mantar? That's stupid.
Even she would say that. Yes.
She would. So, I mean, that's how you know she's the one. Anyway.
I could just imagine going through, like, speed dating again. So, what are your thoughts on Mantar?
Next. Check, please. Anyway, his real name is... Oh, thanks for looking it up. His real name is Mike Ralick. Okay.
Mike Rallick, if you're watching us, give us money!
Give us money, Mike Rallick, and contact the Warcraft people. I'm serious. You should be Mantar. Yeah.
We will help. I will continue the legacy of Mantar.
Start a Kickstarter, and we will contribute.
Yes. I will carry that buffalo head with pride.
Mantar 2016. Anyway.
I'm going to make Mantar great again.
How can you make something great if it never was?
Shut up. People had different expectations in the 90s.
So I love how you went from your least favorite wrestler, and now you're like wanting to fund him. For a wrestler, anyway. Let me think about it. So I was gonna say the Great Khali, but I kind of came in on the tail end of the Great Khali, so I feel like that won't count.
He only suffered like 2 years of his like 8 year tenure with the WWE. So
exactly. So let's see again. The modern day, my least favorite in this 3 years I've been watching. Today, my least favorite wrestler. We already covered Eva Marie. My least favorite male wrestler. I think I'll probably go the main roster because I pretty much love everybody in NXT. I will go with. Damn. Who's one I never like seeing in the ring? Like, every time I saw this person. And no, not Roman Reigns or Cena. Fuck. This is a tough one. Hang on.
You're looking it up, or...
No. I just need to think about this. Like, who is somebody I always, like, besides The Miz. I won't give it to The Miz, because he is a hard worker.
Yeah.
This is a tough one. I'm sorry. Hold on. Back to me.
Ashton's least favorite website is RomanReigns.com.
And you can believe that. Anyway.
Yeah, believe dot that.
Believe dot that. Yeah, I'm kind of thinking like along the lines of like tag teams. Like there have been like tag teams where I'm like, I like that guy, but I hate that guy. So let me think for a second. Gosh, sorry, I shouldn't take this long. I'm just gonna go ahead and say, shit.
Sin Cara.
Why don't we take some comments? What? Yeah, Sin Cara. Yeah, no, that's not fair. Again, not really fair. I kind of came in on the tail end of Sin Cara's fails. So.
His botch ratio. He hasn't met his botch quota in a while.
Yeah, it has been a while. Okay, here's one. I kind of watched him for a while. I really did not like, again, you know, he left the company a while ago, but I was never a huge fan of Brodus Clay.
Alright, fair point.
Yeah, I really hated Brodus Clay. I know, I guess, you know, the whole Funkadactyls gimmick was good for a little while, but when I came in, and I remember when I came in about, you know, 2013 and everything, the Funkadactyls were still going, the whole Brodus Clay thing. And every time that came on, I'm just like, oh, God, I hate this, you know? So, I mean, once he left, I was like, good riddance and all that, and I hope he's doing okay wherever he is. I think he's doing indie shit as a new name now.
I think he might still be in TNA.
Is he still in TNA? He was,
Tyrus,
yeah, and TNA. I hope he's doing good, but I hated seeing him. No offense. I just thought it was a stupid gimmick.
I could just imagine Brodus Clay watching this like, what did you say, Sean?
Funkadactyls, play me off.
Somebody call my mama.
Yeah, just every time he came out, I just did not like the gimmick. I mean, I felt like he was kind of going for like, because, you know, he was a big guy. He almost felt like he was trying to go for like a white Notorious B.I.G. gimmick or something. He was like a rapper, quote unquote, maybe like a pimp or a thug or something.
He was trying too hard to be like Rikishi.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, he tried too hard to be Rikishi. That's a good comparison. I just every time he came on the screen, I'm like, I don't like this guy. So I mean, and that's saying something because I hated The Miz too.
Thank your lucky stars that he didn't wear that high ass sumo thong.
Yeah, I don't need to see that. No, thank you. And Ashton says, Botoxomania? Love that show.
All right, so we got our least favorite female and male wrestlers out of the way. Favorite manager?
Okay, I think that's pretty easy for me, but you go ahead if you want to. You want to go first or me?
Let's see. If I had to pick my favorite manager, I would probably have to say Bobby the Brain Heenan.
Yep, I know how much you love Bobby the Brain.
Yeah, like, I mean, the thing that makes Bobby the Brain Heenan so great is that not only was he the perfect mouthpiece for anybody, but he was able, he was able to talk with the best of them. He was able to entertain, and he was able to entertain from just, you know, sitting up, you know, standing right by ringside, and just pounding the apron. You know, his bits with the weasel suit and all that stuff. Like, and hell, even his commentary career with Gorilla Monsoon is just. Yeah, Heenan. Oh God, I do feel horrible for Bobby Heenan though today.
Yeah. I was thinking about that.
It's so goddamn sad to see him the way he is. I mean, yeah, like my heart does go out to Bobby the Brain Heenan, his friends, his family, his fans, of whom I happen to be a fan. And you know, just like I said, you know, keep doing what you're doing, Brain. If Gorilla Monsoon couldn't shut you up, cancer sure as hell wouldn't.
Oh yeah.
But yeah, like he was able to entertain beyond the traditional means of a manager, and that, and like I said, just he elevated just about everybody. He elevated just about anybody who would take on his services, and that's what a manager's supposed to do.
Hell yeah, and Ashton, you know, I love you, kid, but you know, you go from I feel bad for Bobby today. My favorite manager is Jack. See, you're not helping your case, okay?
I'm starting to think you're bipolar.
Well, yeah, really. I mean, you are good cop and bad cop with this. Anyway.
Yeah, dude. Like good cop and bad cop intermingled in the same body, man. It's sort of scaring me a little bit.
Guys, so I wanted to stay positive. Yeah, no, I mean, the power of positivity is important. New Day rocks, but,
anyway, yeah.
I always love doing Kofi Kingston's clap.
Yeah, dude.
Anyway, my favorite manager, well, I think eventually my favorite manager, depending on the developments, will probably be Bob Backlund to Darren Young. But other than that, I love those promos.
I'm here in Kill Devil Hills, North Carolina. It takes about 3 days to get here by walking. Not by running, by walking.
I love that shit. Like, you can... Oh, shoot, man. He's in Kill Devil Hills? Just like, oh, shit, what's his name? The guy who's been at Walmart a couple times now? Russian.
Yeah, Ivan Kolov.
Yeah. They should form a tag team, but yeah, no, I really love those promos with Bob Backlund. You can so tell that...
He's right.
He's right, thanks, Jared. Jared, yay!
Yeah, Jared, show your.
Hey, come on.
Welcome to the Drunken Fools Wrestling Podcast, Jared.
Huh? What's he saying?
He's saying welcome to the Drunken Fools Podcast.
Okay. Welcome and goodbye.
Welcome and goodbye. Thanks, right, buddy.
Jared Anghong, everybody.
Jared Anghong, everybody, give him a round of applause. Isn't he ugly? Anyway, so now I feel bad for saying other comments. Sorry, guys. Hi, Simpsons member. Oh, no.
You're going to fit in right well.
Oh, geez. A cool scene. The Asian guy making a cameo. Yep. He has to. It's his obligations.
Yeah. Part of his contract.
But no, talking about Bob Backlund real quick, I just love those promos because it's so obvious he's reading from his script. He's like looking down and everything, but it's still so great. Anyway.
I mean, here's the thing. If I know that you're a fairly newer fan, you see, to put some history into it, Bob Backlund is the second longest reigning WWE champion of all time, only behind Bruno Sammartino. And in the 70s, he was basically your wholesome cold cut, clean cut. Yeah, like all American. This is the perennial role model of who you should be. Yeah, like he wrestled again in the 90s for the WWE and also won the WWE Championship again. But this time he was older, and they basically made him like the crazy old man character that we all know and love him to be today.
Sure. And if he was one half of a tag team, they would be the Cold Cut Combo. Anyway, I'm sorry. Let's play a game. Instead of Where's Waldo, let's play Where's Jared Simpson's Edition.
I have a feeling Jared would look like Frank Grimes.
Yeah, really. Actually, yes. Yes, very much so. But, okay, so my answer for my manager is going to be, I'm between two in my modern day era. I really do like, I have seen several matches, though, with Jimmy Hart. Jimmy, the Mouth of the South. I'm between two. I will go ahead and say, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Paul Heyman. Yeah. So I was between Heyman and Zeb Coulter. I'll go with Paul Heyman because, as you know, as you guys might not know, I really got into Paul Heyman. Really liking Paul Heyman as a person and as a manager through watching the ECW DVDs that I want to say you provided me with.
I did, yeah. The Rise and Fall behind of ECW.
Rise and Fall of ECW. I watched a lot of Paul Heyman ate soap. I'm the Mouth of the North. I'm the Mouth of the North. I could see that. Paul Heyman ate soap, did he? Wait, I'll have to watch that segment. But
soap in a segment. Basically, it was he put John Cena in a match with Rhino, where if John Cena lost, you know, he was being you know, the vulgar white rapper John Cena at that time. So if John Cena lost, he would have to wash his mouth out with soap. Instead, John Cena won, and of course, this is around the Chris Benoit angle that I was talking about last week. So Chris Benoit comes out, puts Paul Heyman in the sharpshooter, and ergonomics instead. But I'll let that sink in. But anyway, you know, like John Cena was, you know, just basically just toying around with Paul Heyman, sticking the bar of soap in his mouth, and you know, basically giving Paul Heyman the penance that Paul Heyman created.
I got you. I'll have to see that one. Damn.
I'll send a link to you if I remember.
Okay, yeah, Maurice. Paul Heyman, watching the Rise and Fall of ECW, I really felt bad for the guy because it was clear that he was a very good booker and a very good personality, but obviously we all know he sucked with money.
Exactly.
Yeah, and that's a shame. So, I mean, and that's ironic, right? A Jew that sucks with money, but go figure. Christina Grimmie, yes. Rest in peace, Christina Grimmie.
Yeah, we forgot to mention Christina Grimmie, but we did mention everything that happened in Orlando, so...
That sucks. Yeah, I can't believe it happened back-to-back, but yeah, it's Christina Grimmie. I can't say I was a fan of hers. I honestly did not really know much about her. I knew about The Voice, but...
Yeah, I didn't even watch The Voice here, so I didn't even know who it was until, oh, that's the chick from The Voice. And, you know, I don't mean to sound disrespectful in that. I'm just giving my personal recollection.
No.
Yeah, right. It's still, regardless, very unfortunate.
Yeah, it is. And I found out about it through Lloyd Alquist's time, or at least newer. And he was very heartbroken about it. So I was just like, come on, man. Why does this shit have to happen? And then Pantera shared about it, saying, you know, we thought we were over this after Dimebag. What the fuck, you know?
Wasn't that like the anniversary of the death of Dimebag, or?
No, Dimebag died in December.
Oh, okay. I was thinking it was June for some reason or other, but
I got you. Yeah, no, it was. I'm sorry, go ahead.
Moving right along, we got a funniest moment.
Yeah, let's lighten this up. All right, funniest moment.
Yeah, funniest moment.
Oh, I didn't talk much about Paul Heyman. Let me finish up really quick. I'm sorry. One more thing. Just real quick with Paul Heyman. The reason I picked Paul Heyman is because of his feud storyline, whatever, with CM Punk. I love that storyline. Anyway, cool. Yeah. Moving right along.
Moment.
Yes.
Let's see. Do you have one in particular in mind, Sean?
I've watched a lot of old stuff and I've watched a lot of new stuff. It's a funniest moment, man. That's tough. Do you have anything off the top of your head?
I have one, and it is of Edge and Kurt Angle.
Okay, let's hear it.
Well, actually, the other one that I just thought of also has Edge, but I'll talk about this one. It's 2002. Kurt Angle's about to have a match and everything. He's just, you know, it was announced that Hulk Hogan was going to be the number one contender to the World Championship and or the WWE title. And Kurt Angle is, of course, you know, not too elated that Hulk Hogan gets a shot at the WWE title and Kurt Angle doesn't. Edge comes in. They're in the middle of their rivalry, and you know, he just just real calmly, "Hey, Kurt, you know, I know that we've had some problems lately, and I found these
Ashton.
Ashton. I don't like it.
Ashton, God damn it. Anyway, tell your parents they need to put you on Ritalin. No, I'm just kidding. Anyway, I'm messing.
Great the way you are, man. You're great the way you are.
No, you are. You are.
Anyway, he's just like, you know, I know we've had some problems recently, but I was going through my attic and found these pictures, and you know, they're you know, regular glosses and everything.
I'm just kidding, Ashton. I'm kidding.
Yeah, don't worry. Yeah, don't worry about a thing, man. You're all right. You're already in our books.
Absolutely. Anyway.
Yeah, like on the back though, where just, you know, like Kurt Angle would hold the picture up and down Ritalin boy.
Damn it. Good job, Steve.
He would hold the picture up and, you know, it'd be like, "P.S. I suck." And, you know, like, "I'm a dork." And then, you know, like the last one was the best because, like, it had an arrow pointing down, and over that it had, "P.S. I have no testicles." And then realizing that there were messages on the back, and he just storms out all pissed off. It's hilarious.
Oh my god, that's awesome. What we love you, Ashton. Stay the way you are, man. I'm just messing.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, dude. Anyway, do you have one in mind, or?
There's so many, like, I could probably list a Goldust moment, or I could list a New Day moment, or hell, you know what? I'll go with one that's not so obvious. It's not the funniest moment I've ever seen, but it's one that's definitely coming to my mind. It involves Dean Ambrose, because I love Dean Ambrose. One of the funniest ones, and no, not the Ice Bucket Challenge where he dumped ice on Seth Rollins' head. That was great. But just a moment that really sticks in my mind that I always really enjoyed was when he had a tag match with John Cena to fight Kane. I think it was Kane and Big Show?
I think so.
Might have been Kane and Big Show. So I really like this moment though. So Dean Ambrose is like in the back, you know the moment I'm talking about. I'm just gonna say it for the fans. Dean Ambrose is in the back on a couch eating popcorn, watching See No Evil 2 with Kane, starring Kane. Yeah. And I just love how he's watching. He gets like so scared watching, he's like eating. And then John Cena comes in, he's just like, "What are you doing? This is how you get prepared for a match? Movie night?" And Ambrose is like, no, you gotta get inside your mind, you gotta figure this out. Kane, this Kane guy, he's a freak, he's a weirdo. Yeah, you know, I just love that segment. Like, Dean Ambrose, that's how he gets prepared for a match, watching a movie of his opponent. I loved it. Like, I just, like, started busting out laughing at that moment. And, you know, making me think of that makes me think of the fact that Rusev is now in a movie holding a gun. Go figure.
Like, there's no rhyme or reason. If you're to see this without context, you're just thinking to yourself, "What the fuck?" Just like we were when we were at that Greenville show.
What about the Greenville show?
You know, when they were showing the trailer of that Dollar Kane buddy cop movie or whatever.
Oh yeah, yeah. When they showed it, yeah. So guys, yeah, on this,
and just without rhyme or reason, there's Rusev in his wrestling gear holding a handgun against somebody.
Seriously, fans, Ashton, all y'all, Steve, look this up. There's a WWE movie starring Dolph Ziggler and Kane as buddy cops, and Rusev's in it in his wrestling attire holding a gun at Dolph Ziggler. Why? It's so weird!
Okay, the other one I was talking about, the stuff that Edge and Christian did with Mick Foley was pure comedy gold. Like, one moment that really sticks out in particular is Edge and Christian. They're supposed to be in a tag team title match defending the tag titles against The Rock and The Undertaker.
Wow.
Obviously, they're trying to weasel their way out of it.
So oh, yeah.
Trying to, So they're trying to think up of ways to do it. So I think Christian comes up with the idea of telling the medical staff that both of them have genital warts. That way, nobody will want to touch them, and they'd be out of the match. Then Mick Foley comes in and says that if they do anything to try to get out of the match, then they'll be stripped of the tag team titles. You know, Mick Foley, commissioner at the time, and you know, just that was another comedic goal mine. Mick Foley is commissioner.
Oh my God.
Yeah. So you know, like, so what happened was, Mick Foley leaves the room and then comes back and he's just like, "I'll have you know that, you know, like it's like this PSA. I'll have you know that genital warts do not rule. They are painful and embarrassing." All right, Ashton, do what you do, buddy.
Oh my God! Okay, Ashton, we'll see you in a little bit. Oh my God! So on Mick Foley talking about genital warts. On that note, let me go get some pizza, and I'll be right back.
Totally the perfect thing to talk about before dinner. Genital warts.
Right? With Mick Foley, I want to see that segment on Holy Foley.
Oh God! Trying to.
I want to see him talking to his daughters about genital warts.
Noel, genital warts are not cool. They're painful? And also embarrassing. It can be quite embarrassing.
I'll be right back, guys. I'm sorry. I'll be right back.
All right, so I got.
Oh my God.
Hey, Mr. Yates, how you doing, man? You are watching the Drunken Fools of Wrestling podcast. Sean is getting pizza. I ate all of mine. I am very sad. Eat me pizza. I probably shouldn't even be eating pizza because I went to the gym today and really kicked ass. But yeah. Anyway, Sean's getting pizza. We're talking about a few topics. And after that, we will go right into the 2016 mock draft between myself and Sean. Stay tuned for that. And if you have any friends who are wrestling fans, please send them our way to the Drunken Fools of Wrestling through You Now, and we'll give you a shout out. We try to shout as many people out as we can, and yeah. Anyway, if you have any questions that you'd like to send our way, I'll answer as many of them as I can while Sean gets pizza. And Mr. Yates, congratulations on Axel graduating. I am beyond elated for him. Send him my regards. I've not really had any free time in any way, shape, or form in the last week and a half to really post a lot of stuff on Facebook. And I know you're one proud papa. But yeah, cool, Steve, man. You certainly are. Crack open a beer with your son whenever he gets off work, or if he's off work right now, crack open a beer and just have that, man. I hear Jared in the background. Jared. And let's see, I'm okay, there we go. Wow, Peter Frampton.
Yeah, that part was sick. That was, man.
Oh, that's awesome, man. I can't even imagine working.
Yep, pretty much.
Peter Frampton show, that's really cool. Do you have any pro wrestling stories that you'd like to tell with us while we're...
Alright, let's see.
Mr. Yates is with us.
What'd you say?
I said Mr. Yates is with us.
Oh my God, let's see. Congrats, Axel, for graduating. I am. He's with Peter Frampton now. Oh my God, yeah. That's cool. Peter Frampton's at the... Nice.
Done, yep.
That's cool. Hey, hey, Mr. Yates, congratulations. Yeah, yeah, definitely, you should be proud of Axel, man. Definitely.
Yeah. Here we go.
Is this for Axel?
Yep.
Ghost oh, yeah. Axel. Ding.
Ding.
Congratulations.
Mine's more like poop.
Clunk. Mine's a ding, yours is a clunk. But yeah, man, yeah, definitely Mr. Yates. Axel's awesome. Keep on rocking with that. That is a really cool job. I agree. He has a cool job. That is a cool job. What's the oldest old school
wrestlers I know? George. George Wagner.
What was that name?
Gorgeous George. He was basically like the original wrestling villain.
Gorgeous George. Okay. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I'm not as young as I look. I'm actually 79.
Right? Yeah, man. Axel's a really good friend of ours, for sure. You know, it was really great just meeting him every now and then. I think the first time we met him, when I made that video about driving to go see him, I was definitely very nervous because I was like, shit, man. Like, how do you meet somebody who likes your videos? Like, I'm just like...
Yeah. Yeah, this is the first time that Sean's ever met a fan, you know, like, interacted with a fan or something like that, right?
Right. Well, I mean, exactly. So I was just, like, really nervous about it, but it was cool. And having him on our show was one of the best moments. Gorgeous George is old school, yes.
Oh, yeah. He, I mean, I'm not going to say that, you know, like, you know, he's so old school that old school... That, you know, like, that Stones and all that would be older than he is. But George definitely paved the way in more ways than 100.
Hey, to quote that on there, I got a perfect statement from Code Z. I'm so old school, they tore the school down.
All right, so let's continue on.
My favorite, well, in terms of mine, what's the oldest old school wrestler I know? Because, again, not a fan a long time. The oldest old school wrestler that I probably know is, shit, man, based on watching Legends House, Pat Patterson.
Oh, yeah, Pat Patterson, man. That guy is definitely just one of the most amazing workers.
He started the school. That's how old he is. Jeez.
I mean, yeah, like, he basically brought Canada to America in regards to pro wrestling.
Hell yeah, man.
I mean, yeah, Stu Hart, sure, with a dozen Hart kids, but still, you know, like, yeah, just, I mean, going from basically an impoverished kid from a friend, dude, Wahoo McDaniel, Dory Funk, you lucky bastard.
Aren't you lucky? My grandfather, Wahoo, he went Wahoo. Anyway,
I actually learned this. Wahoo McDaniel actually was a member of the original expansion Miami Dolphins.
Oh my God, really?
Real.
What the hell? That's awesome.
You learn something new every day. Just spout that trivia fact to your dad, Sean.
Like, hey, my grandpappy was a member of the Dolphins.
But yeah, Wahoo McDaniel, I think he played for the Broncos for a little bit, and then, Greg the Hammer, yeah, Johnny Valentine, Greg the Hammer, both real good in their times, definitely. But anyway, we're going to move right on along to favorite gimmick.
Damn, Axel's dad knows a lot about this shit, but, yeah, man.
If for any reason whatsoever one of us can't make it to these podcasts, then you are more than welcome to join us, Mr. Yates.
You are a special guest. McDaniel played for Florida State, according to Mr. Yates.
Yep. Wow. He did. He was a Seminole.
All right, so what was the next one, though?
Favorite gimmick.
Okay. He says he's in. All right,
cool. We try to do this every Sunday at about 5:30.
Ish.
Yeah, ish. We were actually pretty good about it this time, so...
Even I got on 5:30. I'm so proud of myself.
Yeah, yeah. Pat yourself on the back, Sean.
My back hurts. Anyway, so favorite gimmick, huh? So favorite gimmick.
Favorite gimmick.
Yeah, I knew you were going to say it. God damn it.
Far and away, forever and a day, I got to say The Undertaker. I don't think any other persona has ever captivated so many people the way that The Undertaker's has. and I will take the memory of going to see The Undertaker at the 25th anniversary to the grave with me, man. That is, it was, I've had the privilege of seeing him live in action twice, and I can't even put legible words to the feeling.
I don't blame you.
You're seconding The Undertaker?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Right. I mean, hey, gimmicks, masked wrestlers being unmasked. Depends on if they can make it work.
Yeah, because I remember WCW did that all throughout the late 90s, and it almost never worked. Almost never worked. You know, yeah. Like the mask, especially Lucha Libre, is a is an integral part of a lot of wrestlers. Pardon me. A lot of wrestlers' identities. And
yeah,
I think that's always been one of my least favorite stations. I mean, Rey Mysterio had to be unmasked in WCW.
Used to be a franchise, and then the spoilers. Who's the spoilers?
Oh, gosh,
Mr. Yates. Who are the spoilers?
Yeah. You're the fount of old school wrestling knowledge. Oh, God.
We're the fountain of youth. Anyway.
Spoiler number one. Oh, okay. So basically they were named numerically.
Gotcha. Okay.
But,
they said numbers. Yeah.
So basically it kind of reminds me of, the Vianos.
Vianos?
Yeah. They were a Mexican family of pro wrestlers. I think it was like, Viano 1 through Viano 6.
Gotcha.
Yeah, I remember them. I remember they had, like, I think, Viano 4 and Viano 5 in WCW for a while. But yeah, so favorite gimmick for me, Undertaker. Favorite gimmick for Sean, also Undertaker. We'll do one more before we go to the mock draft.
Real quick, I will say this to you, Mr. Yates, about the unmasking. Hopefully one that works out. I don't know how into new school wrestling you are, but hopefully one that works out is Andrade Cien Almas. He just debuted in NXT. He was originally La Sombra. I saw him at a house show. Since you're tuning in now, I saw him at a house show. It was Manny Andrade. Had a match with Austin Aries. Phenomenal. And so far, hopefully his unmasking will be good. We'll see. Only time will tell. So...
All right, so, yeah, if you don't already have it, the WWE Network is $9.99 a month, and WWE, give me your money.
Pretty much.
And so, yeah, it is totally worth it, if nothing else, for these three letters, NXT.
Yeah, exactly. Mr. Yates, I cannot recommend, he cannot recommend NXT enough. So.
Exactly. You also get access to all the pay-per-views as they come along. You get basically every past pay-per-view from WCW, ECW, WCW, and even a lot of the old territory stuff nowadays.
Exactly. You can watch anything pretty much on there. Yeah. Except you can't search Chris Benoit. But.
Well, yeah. Don't look into it. Get it.
Just get it.
Get it now.
All right. We won't tell you what to do. Anyway, what's the next topic?
Okay, this is going to be the last one we touch on before the mock draft. Favorite memory?
I think I got mine.
Okay, do tell.
Well, as much as I really liked watching TNA, well, my first pay-per-view watching TNA Slammiversary with you and DJ, my favorite memory will have to be last year when you and I went to Monday Night Raw and Kevin Owens debuted.
Oh, yes.
That was amazing.
It really was, man. I mean, like, sadly, I feel like we were the only ones that really popped.
No, we were the only ones who knew what the hell was going on. I was like, as soon as I heard that music, I'm like, this is... Exactly. I was like, this isn't NXT. What the hell?
Yeah, it took me a second to realize that's Kevin Owens' music, but, you know, like, once the Sonic came, I was like, that's not NXT.
No.
And then after the first da-da-da-da, I'm just like... That's Kevin Owens.
No. Like, yeah, exactly. It's like that dawning moment.
Oh, man.
I felt like the guy from, I felt like the guy who watched The Undertaker lose, the black guy.
Oh, yeah.
I felt like that guy. I was like,
I mean, there's no way that you can replicate that face. No way in hell.
Oh, no. That's why he's so famous. Bruno Sammartino versus Jesse Ventura. Yes.
Oh my god, dude. Yes. Yes.
Damn, did you see that match live, Mr. Yates?
Yeah. Oh man. For me, my favorite memory of pro wrestling probably has to be
Jesse used to scare me.
He still scares me.
He's a scary man. He ain't got time for fear. Saw it on TV. Yeah. Okay. Gotcha.
But, god damn. My favorite memory of pro wrestling probably has to be, god, it is so hard because...
Well, didn't you see Ric Flair live?
Yeah, twice.
That's a pretty good memory, but no, what do you got? I'm sorry.
But, yeah, it's so hard because, like, I've been a fan for almost 20 years, and there are so many memories to pick from. I'd probably have to say, because this is one of my earliest memories, he was very scary, rubber band through cheek.
Safety pin through brow.
Captain Lou Albano.
That does sound like Albano.
Yeah, that's Lou Albano. But yeah, one of the earlier memories that I remember is when Sting joined the NWO Wolfpack.
Mm.
Yeah, like Sting just swerved them perfectly. You know, like Sting comes descending from the rafters like he used to do, and he's got the black and white face paint on. He's got an NWO black and white shirt on under his
Jesse did before Captain Lou, apparently. Huh?
Okay.
Wow.
He was wearing an NWO black and white T-shirt under his trench coat. And, you know, like, just doing the whole, brother, that sort of thing. And then, like, he just takes his baseball bat and just shunts it into somebody. And then just rips off the NWO black and white shirt to reveal NWO black and red. I mean, like I said, it killed the entire mystique of the Sting character. But it was such a sweet swerve.
Hmm. Damn.
Yeah, that's fair. I think he also wound up scoop slamming the Giant as well in that scene, which made it even better. So, yeah, like I'd have to say that's the favorite memory that I can immediately think of. It's one of my earliest as a wrestling fan.
I got you. I bet you have quite a few. Yeah.
So.
Now, Mr. Yates, I will say this, Mr. Yates. He may have done it before Captain Lou Albano, but Jesse Ventura could not do the Mario, okay?
He couldn't swing his arms
from side to side. Come on, let's have to go do the Mario. Anyway, the Mario...
The less you know about that, the better.
No. I'm helping Mr. Yates. Mr. Yates, the Super Mario Brothers Super Show existed at one time, and Captain Lou Albano played the live-action Mario. Look it up.
Yes.
Anyway, he was a Navy SEAL. He was.
Yeah, Jesse.
He was.
Who, Jesse Ventura or Lou Albano?
I think, God. No, not Lou Albano. He would never be.
Lou Albano, I don't ever think would have ever had the... Oh, okay. That's that makes more sense.
Yeah, just Lou Albano was like freaking damn.
So anyway, that's what we're doing from the 30 Days of Wrestling challenge list this week. Next, tune in next week. We will be on article number 15 of that. So I pitched this idea to Sean when I started having the idea of the podcast, since Raw and SmackDown are again going to be split into separate shows.
July 19th.
With unique rosters. I figure, you know, we may as well do our own mock draft.
Okay, this is going to be tough for me. This is going to be tough.
So we'll do rock, paper, scissors. We'll do it twice. The winner gets to choose what show they get to run and with the first throw. And then the second throw gets the... winner gets the first draft pick.
Gotcha. Okay, ready? Rock, paper, three. Oh, you can't see it. Shit. Do it again. Okay, right here. Here we go. Rock.
One,
two, three. Go. I had scissors.
Okay, so what show do you want to run? See you, Mr. Yates. It's been fun.
That's a balance punch we have for this. Okay, cool. Thank you. Yep. See you, Mr. Yates. Hell yeah.
So, what show do you run, Sean?
Shit. I'll run SmackDown.
So, Sean gets SmackDown.
And I'll get Raw.
I'll make SmackDown great again. Hashtag.
Alright, do I have a... thought maybe I'd have like a quarter or something so we could do a coin toss because the... Okay. I don't.
Okay.
So here we go.
Okay, hold on. Okay, ready? Okay, I'm just making sure it's on screen. Okay, ready?
Ready.
One, two, three.
Paper. Yep, paper.
Okay, ready?
Okay, try again.
Mm-hmm. Right,
one,
two, three.
Huh.
I had Rock. Yeah, I had Rock. It's kind of hard to do it over the broadcast, yeah.
Yeah, it really is.
You want me to flip a coin? Hang on, hang on.
Yeah, you got like a quarter somewhere?
I have a dime. Okay, ready?
All right.
Here we go. Heads or tails? Call it.
I'll do tails.
Tails. I'm going to let it fly, and it is tail. No, wait. Heads. Heads.
All right. So you get the first pick of the draft.
Okay. Hang on a second. I need to think about this for one second.
And the main rule is, the main rules are as follows: the WWE Championship or the WWE Champion Roman Reigns is invalid for the draft. The Women's Champion Charlotte is invalid for the draft, and the Tag Team Champions The New Day are invalid from the draft, all for obvious reasons.
Because you don't know which. Okay, that's fair. Yeah.
Yeah. However, The Miz is the Intercontinental Champion, is up for drafting, and States Champion, who's the U.S. champ? Rusev is up for the draft as well.
Okay, hold up, one second. No way. What? So I just pulled up the WWE roster. It says Bo Dallas is filming a movie. What movie?
Wait, I gotta see this shit.
Are you seeing what I'm seeing?
I see it, dude.
What are you looking at? Are you looking at the Wikipedia page, or what are you looking at? It says he's...
All three members of the Social Outcasts are... And The Miz.
What?
And... Yeah.
What? Are they in that shitty Dolph Ziggler Kane movie or something, or what?
I would think so.
That's... Okay, so all three of the Social Outcasts are filming this movie. Is it Social Outcast the movie, or what? That's so weird.
But anyway, anybody in the main roster, except for the champions I mentioned and part-timers, are invalid.
Okay. All right. So my pick first?
Yes.
All right. Well, I'm trying to be careful because I want to pick and choose about whole like rivalries and stuff. But my first pick will be Kevin Owens.
KO Mania is coming to SmackDown.
Mm-hmm.
My first pick is going to be, for Monday Night Raw, I need ratings, and nobody gets ratings like this guy does, John Cena.
Chat! I can't believe it. I wish I was recording this. You just drafted John Cena for your first pick. I wish I was recording this right now. Wow.
I think the shit archives, so.
Right? Damn, I can't believe you just picked John Cena. Wow.
You see, I'm running a show, and like I said, ratings, bitch.
You fucking hypocrite. That's all I gotta say. Fucking hypocrite. Just kidding. Alright, so that's your first pick. We can choose men and women, right?
Yes.
Okay. So for my second pick, I'll go with Sasha Banks.
Sasha Banks, alright. Let's see. My second pick... So Roman Reigns, New Day, and Charlotte are all unavailable. My second pick is going to be the phenomenal AJ Styles.
Good pick. Yeah, I forgot about AJ Styles. Okay, next.
Third round.
Fight. I'm just looking at the roster in case I don't forget anybody. For my next pick, I will go ahead and go with Cesaro.
Cesaro, all right.
Yep, I'll keep Kevin Owens and Cesaro on SmackDown because I feel like those two could have a good feud.
I cannot blame you there. Let's see. My third pick, I am going to go with...
Hmm. How many rounds are we doing, by the way?
10.
10? Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
I will go with... I went with Cena. I went with Styles. Dean Ambrose.
I was going to go Ambrose, but I went with Cesaro. Nice pick.
Yeah, man.
Also, look at this list. I love how Heath Slater's real name is Heath Miller. What was that, unavailable since it's a Steeler, he was the Steelers tight end?
He's retired now. He can use it.
Now he can use it. Yeah, that's so weird. I love how John Cena's real name is still John Cena, though. He's like the only wrestler who that's his real name.
Well, I mean, there's Brock Lesnar.
And Mark Henry, actually. Mark Henry is Mark Henry. Brock Lesnar is Brock Lesnar. Randy Orton is technically Randall Orton, but he can get away with Randy.
Well, the thing is, like, it wasn't until WrestleMania 19 where the main event featured two guys who had their actual real names as their wrestling personas, Kurt Angle and Brock Lesnar.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Did not know that. Yeah, most of them don't use their real name. And to be fair, I'm glad they don't, because some of these names, man, Cesaro's real name is Claudio Castagnoli. Oh, my God.
He used that in the indies, man.
He was that in the indies, Claudio Castagnoli?
Yeah.
Gotcha. I mean, some of these names are really... Oh, God, I'm really glad Apollo Crews is Apollo Crews. Do you see his name?
Apollo Crews. Oh, yeah, Sesu Uha.
Sesu Uha. Doesn't quite roll off the tongue.
No.
Jeez. All right, so we're in the fourth round?
Fourth round.
All right. Let's see. I will go ahead and go with... Let's see. Who do I have so far? I have Kevin Owens, Cesaro, and...
Sasha Banks.
And Sasha Banks. Let's go ahead and go with... Who do I want to go with? I don't know if I want to risk breaking up tag teams. I will go ahead and draft. Yeah, okay. I'll go ahead and draft, Apollo Crews. Why not?
Apollo Crews, all right. I am with the fourth round of the... Oh, we just got into our mock draft. We are in the fourth round. To recap, Sean got the first pick and selected Kevin Owens. With his second pick, he selected Sasha Banks. Third pick, Cesaro. Fourth pick, Apollo Crews.
Yup.
I'm currently on my fourth pick, yet to be determined. Number one, I picked John Cena.
Hypocrite, right?
Ratings, bitch!
That's why I drafted Kevin Owens. Ratings, bitch!
Anyway. Number two, I selected AJ Styles. And number three, Dean Ambrose.
And side note, we made it a rule not to draft pretty much any of the champions, so no Roman Reigns, no New Day. What about the U.S. champion?
Rusev and The Miz are still available for draft.
Gotcha. Okay, so we can't draft the New Day or Roman Reigns, so keep that in mind, Ashton.
Or Charlotte.
Or Charlotte, the women's champion.
If we have time, we will.
We'll try.
Yeah. My fourth round pick, I select Bray Wyatt.
Bray Wyatt. I was thinking about Bray Wyatt. I was. Good pick.
I was hoping you didn't pick him, man.
Yeah, he should probably stay on Raw, to be honest.
Yeah.
Okay, so fifth round. Let's see. What about The Undertaker? Is he available?
He's a part-timer, so...
Yeah, so no Undertaker and no Brock Lesnar, right?
Yeah.
Okay, none of the part-timers. I will go ahead, for my next pick, I will go ahead and go with, let's see, I'll go with Baron Corbin.
Baron Corbin, all right. I am going to go with... My fifth round pick. Where to go with this? I will say my.
No, Ashton. No, we're not going with anyone who's fired, retired, or passed away.
Yeah, this is of the current main roster.
Yeah, because Raw and SmackDown are splitting up again. So.
Yeah, this is the whole reason we're even doing this.
Yeah.
Let's see.
My fifth round pick, I am going to select... the United States champion, Rusev.
Rusev, nice pick, nice pick. I will go ahead for my next pick. I will go with... Yep, gotta have a great few for Kevin.
Sean, you're kind of frozen, man.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you now.
Okay, I said to have a great few with Kevin Owens, I'm going Sami Zayn.
All right. Damn, that was going to be my next one.
Nope.
Yeah, you just totally grumpy cat me, man.
Nope. Okay.
Let's see. For my next pick, I am going to select. This is going to be a ballsy move. Seth Rollins.
Seth Rollins, okay. Good move. Before I make my next pick, I was just looking on the Wikipedia page, and the name of the... Did you see the name of the tag team that Paul Ellering is
managing? No.
They're apparently called the Authors of Pain. I like that.
Authors of Pain, all right.
I like that. I mean, it fits the style because he did manage the the Road Warriors and the Legion of Doom. Author of Pain feels like the third movie that we needed. Yeah, sure.
Exactly. That'll be like the Return of the Jedi of tag team trilogy.
Right. He has such great tag teams.
Oh yeah, man. Number seven.
Seventh round. Let's see. Seventh round. I will go with. Alright, everyone say it with me, man. Hashtag make Dolph great again. Let's go with Dolph Ziggler.
Alright, Dolph Ziggler, excellent.
Let's make him great again, come on.
Let's see.
I have mainly faces, I just realized, anyway.
I am going to select Big Cass.
Big Cass, okay. And you can't teach that. I feel bad about choosing Enzo Amore, then. I'm not going to choose Enzo Amore. Let's see. You know what? You're going to go with Big Cass? I'm going to go with Aiden English.
Aiden English, all right.
Yeah.
Let's see. I, for my next pick, will select... I was going to pick Kofi Kingston, but he's part of New Day, but...
Yeah, can't do that.
And you can't do that!
He can't do that!
Let's see, guys really getting to the nitty-gritty on this one, man, already.
Right.
I am going to go ahead and select Enzo.
Okay, go ahead and take Enzo.
Yep.
I'm going to take Simon Gotch.
All right.
I'm looking at this. They really did pick a good name for Big E. He really should just be called Big E because his real name is Hattori Ewan.
Yes.
Or whatever. Yeah, so E-E. So might as well just be Big E. Good name. Yeah.
Yeah. Let's see. Ninth round.
Fight!
Oh, Jesus. I'm going to go ninth round pick the Intercontinental Champion, The Miz.
Wow. All right.
That way I got both champions on my show.
That's fair. Eh, who knows how long they'll be champions. I already picked the guy who should be the IC title champion, Cesaro. Let's see. I mean, he won it twice, but the referee wasn't looking.
Those were live shows, Sean. They don't count in the WWE canon.
Oh, they count. I mean, dude, live shows count? Freaking Samoa Joe won the NXT title at LOL.
Not, okay. Most house shows don't count.
Yeah, I know. Let's see. I feel good with my picks. Let's see. But I want to go with. Let's see. Who do I want to pick here? Screw it. We got the small running guys too. So let's go Kalisto.
That's actually not a bad one.
No, I think Kalisto would be good.
Let's see. My final pick. Where do I go with this one?
Mark Henry.
I will select with my final pick. Picked.
Yeah, you picked him. Primo!
I may as well pick Spike Dudley Ball, man.
Oh, I know you should pick.
John Cena!
You already did that, traitor. No. To keep the U.S. title going, pick Titus O'Neil.
That's not a bad pick at the moment, but who knows how long that's going to be.
Right. How about Goldust?
This last one has got to close out strong, man.
Right.
Let's see.
Oh, I see somebody you should pick, but I'm not going to tell you.
Since the women's championship is available for both shows, my final pick is going to be Paige.
Paige, there you go. Ashton, unfortunately, Stardust is no longer with us. Cody Rhodes is currently having a match with Kurt Angle in August, I believe.
In New York, yep.
That's awesome. And he says thanks for becoming his fan, by the way. Ashton,
yeah, I saw that.
Cool. Yeah, dude, man. Stardust, man. He got to have a shitty gimmick and now he gets to have a match with Kurt Angle. Lucky him.
Yeah, man. So to recap, Sean O'Keefe's SmackDown consists of Kevin Owens, Sasha Banks, Cesaro, Apollo Crews, Baron Corbin, Sami Zayn, Dolph Ziggler, Aiden English, Simon Gotch, the Vaudevillains, and Kalisto.
Kalisto. I went mostly new.
All right. And I went with my first pick being John Cena.
Hypocrite.
AJ Styles.
Yep, good pick.
Dean Ambrose.
Good pick.
Bray Wyatt. Rusev. Seth Rollins. Big Cass. Ed Morey. The Miz. And Paige.
All except for The Miz. But, yeah.
I basically chose The Miz so that I could have both the Intercontinental and U.S. titles on my show.
That's fair.
And The Miz is not a bad wrestler. He's just an annoying gimmick, but but he's one of the only people on the roster who can get legit heel heat.
I mean, hey, come on, man. He's not a bad wrestler. He's not a good wrestler. He's the wrestler.
He's not Mickey Rourke. What the fuck are you talking about?
Yeah, Mickey Rourke comes on. I'm not a good wrestler. I'm not a bad wrestler. I'm the wrestler. God.
So who do you think drafted better?
Who do you think drafted better? Leave your comments below, Ashton. It was pretty much me. It was obvious. I picked Apollo Crews and Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens. Come on.
I got all the ratings getters. I got the unique gimmicks. I got Seth Rollins.
NXT.
All the champions. And Enzo and Cass.
Hey, Enzo and Cass were never NXT Tag Team Champs. Vaudevillains were.
Yeah, for like a cup of coffee.
But yeah, I mean, it really was. Yeah, that really did suck. But yeah. All right. We have anything else to talk about?
I am the draft champion.
Oh, bullshit. Where's Steve when I need him? He has my name, for God's sake. He'll pick me.
Does anybody have any ideas for topics for next week's episode? If so, then sound off in the comments.
Oh, I have a topic.
Yeah?
It's pretty obvious. Money in the Bank.
Oh, Money in the Bank. That's right.
That's right. Next Sunday. So if we do the show before next Sunday, which I assume we will, we'll discuss the matches and make our picks.
Actually, next Sunday's Father's Day, so we may or may not do a feed on Sunday. If we are not able to do one on Sunday, we'll try to work out a date to where both of us are off and that we can do this. We'll let you know as we know.
Say again, you froze. I'm sorry. Go ahead and say that again.
Okay. Well, anyway, as I was saying, since next Sunday is Father's Day, we may not be doing a Drunken Fools of Wrestling podcast.
Okay.
We will try to do it on a different date. We'll let you know as we know.
Okay. I know you work Saturday nights, but do you have a wedding Saturday night?
Not entirely sure. Schedule comes out on Tuesday, so I'll let you know. I'll let you know when my days off are. You know, when I don't have to work a night shift.
Okay, let me know, Ashton. I'll go ahead and just say this then: if we don't do a show next Sunday, Ashton, you're our fan on Facebook now. So I mean, if anything, you can leave your comments about. I assume you watch WWE pay per views. Leave your comments about who you think will win each match on Money in the Bank. Leave a comment on the Facebook page, and we'll read it. We'll check it out.
Yeah. Well, anyway. For that I am Chuck Beatty, and
I'm Sean
got Keith. Mad Libs.
And I got one more Mad Lib. Let's close this out. Come on.
Yeah, let's close this out. We got to do this right.
Come on, let's close it out. And hold on, say again. He's Chuck Beatty. I'm Sean O'Keefe. We remember, so you don't have to. So let's see. So I'm going to go ahead and pick a Mad Lib. We'll do one more, Ashton, before we close off. Let's see. Foo Fighters. I like this one. All right, here we go. Chuck, let's start you off with a color.
Color, I'm going to say turquoise.
Turquoise? You mean turquoise?
No, turquoise. What the fuck are you talking about?
Turquoise, all right. Ashton, how about a noun? Let's wait. Wait for it. I'll come back to you. Ashton, a noun, and Chuck, a verb.
Verb, I'm going to say... Spring.
Spring?
Yeah, like jump, bounce.
Whatever. Like spring. Okay. That's cool. Spring. See, I thought you said spring for a second. Yeah.
To go with turquoise.
So, Ashton, once again, a noun from you, sir. Let's see if he... Let's wait a second. He already said his wait, what? I didn't see that. The comment didn't come up on my end. I'm sorry. Could you say it again?
Didn't come up on mine either. I'm
sorry. Yeah, type it again. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Suck you now. We're never gonna use you again.
Right. Yeah, no, we seriously didn't receive a comment. I'm serious about that.
Yeah,
I'm sorry.
Dude. Yeah.
Maybe.
Hello. You can do this.
Well, we'll give him a second. Maybe something's screwing up on his end. I don't know. Or on our end. But, Chuck, how about... You're really good with these. How about a place?
Place, I'm going to say... Church parking lot.
Church parking lot. All right. Damn. Yeah, maybe he's having technical difficulties.
All right, so...
You're skipping mine, or
am I crazy?
No, I'm serious, man. We seriously do not see your comments. I'm dead serious. Literally, I can take a screenshot for you. Literally, the last thing that I saw you say was... You said, read my comment up above. I saw that. You picked Chuck as the winner, and then you said, yeah. And then you said, already said mine. I'm not seeing anything. I can take a picture for you. Yeah, something's going on your end.
Oh, shit, Biscuits. Is
hit the comments. Hey, is it raining?
Yeah.
Really?
It wasn't calm for it all day.
Damn. Hit the comments button. I'm in the comments button, buddy. I'm in the chat.
Comment button.
I'm in the comments. I am in the comments. I'm reading your comments right now, but I don't see anything about a noun. Sorry.
Let's see.
Why don't you, if it's not working on your end for whatever reason, why don't you go to our, why don't you send it to me in Facebook Messenger on, I think we're friends now on Facebook. Yeah, send it to me on Facebook Messenger.
Yeah, try that.
Yeah, I'll get on Facebook Messenger if you send it that way. So we'll give you a minute. We'll wait till you, let's see. So Jeff couldn't make it, huh? Mm.
Yeah. Didn't give any kind of reason or anything, so...
Nope. He never really does he?
Well, to be fair, I didn't really give him much headway in, you know, like, hey, podcasting today.
Oh, I gotcha. Yeah, I guess that's fair.
Yeah. Well, if he wants to join us for the next Drunken Fools, if he's able to, he can.
There you go.
You guys get to meet Jeff!
Right, you get to meet Jeff. I'm receiving a call from Ashton on Facebook. Hang on 1 second. Stand by.
Yeah,
hi, what's up?
Hey.
What's up, Ashton? What's up? I did get your message. That's your noun? Really? Oh, God. All right, I'll write it down.
this is already going to be great.
Oh, you already got one for Chuck, too? All right. All right, I'll pick it.
All right.
Okay, yeah, no, that's fine. Why don't we get off this call, though? Because it's kind of awkward, like, hearing Chuck on one end, and you're on one end. It's just kind of awkward on my end, you know what I mean? Yeah.
Sean's losing his...
But no, keep messaging me on Facebook, though, for sure, man. All right, man.
The power of the old...
I will. Can you can hear us. Shut up, Chuck. You can hear us on you now, right? You can actually hear our voices. Okay, cool. I'll let you know when the Mad Lib is done. Yeah. Cool, man. See ya. So, yes, I just received a message from Ashton. He called me on Facebook.
Cool.
Nice. He gave me... I won't tell you what the noun he gave me is, but it'll become prominent. And he also gave me one for you, and I'll go ahead and fill the other noun with that one.
All right.
All right.
You want like that.
Exactly. So I got two nouns from Ashton. So let's go ahead. I will give you a verb past tense, Chuck. And I'll give... And I'll give Ashton a verb ending in ing. So, verb ending in ing.
Did.
What'd you say?
I said thrusted.
Thrusted. Hang on one sec. Thrusted for verb past tense?
Yes.
All right. And like I said, Ashton, message me on Facebook. Verb ending in ing, buddy. All right, Chuck, how about an adjective?
Adjective, let's see, buttery.
Buttery, okay, nice. Let's see, buttery. Wait a second. I assume he heard me, but I'll go ahead and type it out too. Verb ending in ing, just in case you didn't hear me.
Who, me?
Ashton.
Oh, okay.
Cool. For you, Chuck, I'll give you a plural noun.
Let's see. Jared's moms.
Jared's moms? Oh, no. Why, Chuck? Why?
You set this plague upon the world.
Yeah, I know. Well, no, yo, you said this. Okay, anyway. I got the verb ending in ing from Ashton. It is the word heating. Okay? Ashton, give me a type of liquid. I'll go ahead and type it out, too. Type of liquid. And from Chuck, give me a part of the body, singular.
singular part of the body, I am going to say... I'm going to say mustache.
Mustache. All right. And Ashton gave me... He's typing it right now. Raw sewage.
Jesus.
Nice.
That's using your head.
That is using your head. Good job, man. Hang on one second. Good job. All right. So, raw sewage. And I believe that's it. So, okay. Ready, Ashton? I assume you can hear me. It sucks that the comments aren't working for you, but here we go. Foo Fighters and fireworks.
Oh, Lord.
On July 4th, 2015, the Foo Fighters thrusted upon RFK Stadium in the church parking lot.
Where a lot of shit happens.
A lot of shit happens. Hang on one second. Can you hear me, Ashton? I'm going to type it out. Can you hear me? Are we good? Oh, I'm getting a call from Patrick. I will get back to you, Patrick. Let's see. July 4th. So, thrusted upon...
Wrestling Fools podcast?
Yeah, really. Oh, okay. Ashton can comment now.
Okay, cool, okay. Cool, cool.
Okay. Can you hear me? Sorry.
You can't hear me.
Thank you, Def Cena.
What?
Right?
All
right. I think he can. I think he's good. Let's see. Hold on one second. Okay, cool. All right, here we go. Here we go. Ready? All right. Foo Fighters and fireworks. On July 4, 2015, the Foo Fighters thrusted upon RFK Stadium in the church parking lot to celebrate their 20th anniversary in America. But Dave and company, Dave Grohl, but Dave and company don't do small celebrations. No, no. They throw big mustache parties. That's they awesome.
Sure do. They sure do.
They throw big mustache parties with their talented friends. Check out the guest list. Guest list below. We got Trouble Chuckarella. Trouble Chuckarella. Mad Libsifying his name. Pay your heating respect, kids. Okay. Buddy Guy, there's no Mad Libs. No Mad Libsifying his name. Pay your heating respect. Okay. We got LL Buttery.
LL Buttery.
LL Buttery featuring DJ Z Spring. Heart. That's a good choice. Gary Clark Jr. Joan Jett and the Turquoise Hearts. Turquoise Hearts. And thanks a lot for this one, Ashton. Sean the Thong will keep Shorty and Orleans Avenue. Jeez. Sean the Thong. I just like Sean the Thong Shorty. That goes well.
That could be my porn name.
That could be my porn name. And then there's another word. It says RDGLDGRN. What is that? RDGLDGRN. Red. What?
Oh, Red Dragon, I think.
What?
I think that's Red Dragon without any of the vowels.
Is that what that is?
I think so.
I have no idea. But anyway, that. With everyone drinking. Are you there, Chuck? Can you hear me?
Yeah, I'm here. I'm here.
Okay. With everyone drinking plenty of raw sewage.
Oh, no. No! What
you've done, Ashton. With everyone drinking plenty of raw sewage and a loud, colorful Jarrett's Mom's display at night. Oh, God. A loud, colorful Jerry Mom's display at night. It was one incredible celebration of foo and freedom. God bless America.
Yeah, man. With that, we... Oh, hi, Robert H.
Sorry, Robert H. We're just finishing up.
Yeah.
But, we really do. Thank you.
I believe that this is archived or can be archived, and if you wanna watch this, if you are a wrestling fan or just a guy who likes to see two guys in two different states yuck it up,
yuck it up.
Then, yep, then you've come to the right place.
You have. So, I guess there's not much to talk about. We're finishing up right at 8 o'clock, so.
Yep. Dean Ambrose is a good, is he a good wrestler?
Hell yeah, he is.
Yeah.
Be the very best, like no one ever was.
But people are going to screw him over, man. But, no, yeah, go back and watch the archive of this. We did a bunch of stuff, talked about wrestling. We did a mock draft of Raw and SmackDown. I ran SmackDown, Chuck ran Raw, and Chuck picked Dean Ambrose. So check that out, Robert H., and more.
Yep. And if you like what you see from the archive, like I said, this is only our second episode. Just keep recommending this to your friends who happen to be wrestling fans. And, we are the Drunken Fools of Wrestling. And thank you for coming on by.
And awesome. Thank you for becoming a fan.
We appreciate that immensely. Like I said, I don't know how you now archive stuff, but if they do, we have two episodes right now. This is the second. The third one, we typically do these on Sundays, but next week's Father's Day, so we're going to aim for a different day, and we'll let you know as we know.
Absolutely. I mean, I could do it since I'm in Atlanta, but I understand you want to be with your dad.
Well, not only is it Father's Day, but it's also my grandma's birthday.
That's right. Okay, that's cool.
Yeah. Well,
all right.
Actually, it's both my grandmother's birthdays. Both happen to share the same birthday.
So weird. Man, that's so weird. So we'll figure out when we're going to do the next one. Maybe the 26th, or maybe we'll do one before that. We'll figure it out. But if you want to check us out and some of our content, we go by the Factory Boys of Improv. You can check us out by going to youtube.com/FBI Improv, facebook.com/TheFactoryBoys, and twitter.com/TheFactoryBoys. I run those channels. But in the meantime, this is Chuck's show, The Drunken Fools of Wrestling. I'm Sean.
Yep, and like I said, you know, just, you know, just this is two guys talking about wrestling, and you guys are, y'all are awesome, and just, like I said, just tell a friend.
Yeah, and thanks for watching us.
All right, take it easy, guys.
Bye.
Drop you like a bad habit.
Bye.
Drop and end.